Hello, welcome back to the DM's Craft. I'm DM Scotty, nice to see you again. This time, episode 2, we'll be talking about cave tiles. So basically, they're like irregular tiles. The other tiles we did in the first episode were straight edge tiles. These will be irregular edges. And looking forward to showing you. As I did before, I wanted to show you an example of an irregular tile. This is a cave complex I made for a game that I had going on. There's a secret cult hiding out in this cave. So we've got three sections. We've got the entrance section, and this is open here. We've got the main section of the cave with a magic circle in it. And then we've got the final section, which had a hole where one of the creatures could try to escape if the players didn't stop them. So, for example, if you're playing with this, you might set your player characters at the entrance and have these off to the side where the players couldn't see them. And this would be the entrance, and the characters could come on in the entrance. And then as they rounded the corner, or snuck up to the corner here, you could add the bigger part to the dungeon. And as they if they work their way over and could see into this part, then you could add this. So that's a great way to use your tiles to reveal areas. Now, several noticeable things on this tile. It's not the same color as the stone texture. This is actually a brown texture, which is, they have the spray paint that is the brown texture, so that works great, because this was a dugout cave, and I wanted it to have that look. Like a mine, not like a stone quarry. I also put, you can see the edges. I also put little support beams to simulate that the earth was held up. So it kind of gives it a nice little flair. And the circle, basically, I put a round piece of cardboard on top of the dungeon tile, and then I drew the magic circle on there so that it became the centerpiece of the battle. So that's basically the anatomy of the tiles. I've also added some rubble on the tile. I did it the same way with the other that I did with the dungeon tile, and I will be showing that how I did that in a upcoming episode soon. So that's one example, and now I have another example. So this is another example of an irregular piece that I had in an actual dungeon. But you can see the difference between this one and the other one. One of the differences is I have the stone texture, like the other dungeon tiles. This one also has what looks like a murky liquid in it, and kind of chunks of rock that form a natural bridge across that. And so this was a caved-in room, so a very effective way to use an irregular tile to add to a regular dungeon. Same kind of rubbling here. And I'll also show you in a later video how I did this murky, stagnant water effect. So pretty neat. And so those are a few examples of the way you can use irregular tiles. Just a quick note for all my crafter friends. I'm not going to go over all the materials lists that we did for the first video. I'm going to build on those, so I assume you know what materials you need, and you'll see me use them in this video. So I'm just going to get straight into building the tiles. What I'm going to do first is just draw the shape of the cave. So I'll start and make it kind of go like this. A little bit of an interesting shape. And then back to the entrance, and I'm going to bow out the entrance a little bit. Since it's not going to be connected to another tile, it doesn't need to be flat. It'll give it a little more, make it a little more natural instead of just cutting it off. So, so this will be the door. So that's what I've got. So what I'll do next is I'll cut it out with my razor knife. So it can be a little tricky cutting the irregular tiles because they're not straight. So just take your time and be careful. You may have to go over it several times. Okay, so through the magic of time lapse, you can see I've cut the tile out. So I've got the irregular tile. And you notice behind it, I've got the box that has a shape. Now you want to save this shape because it's really going to help you make the walls of your cave. So I will show you that next. All right, so here's the shape I cut out. Now what I'm going to do for the walls is I'm going to do something interesting. I'm just going to trace, here's the doorway. So I don't want to cover that. So I'm going to start here and I'll just kind of trace around with the edge and I'll make it however, whatever thickness I want, kind of guesstimate it. And I'll just trace around. Now this will become the wall of the cave. Oops. Okay, go there. Okay, so now as you can see, I've got the wall of the cave. Now I need to cut this out. So here I'll start cutting, and I'll follow my line. So I get a thin strip. And like I say, you always be careful with this knife, it's very sharp. So I've let my glue gun warm up, and these are the parts I have. I have the exterior wall, and I have the cave tile. So one thing you may have to do when these are regular tiles is sometimes you'll get like, the cutting is a little harder, so you might get some edges that you might need to cut off. So don't get too crazy, because you don't want to change the shape too much from the wall you cut out. Just if you got some little snags, cut those off. And so we should be good to go. Now, one thing you might be thinking is, oh, well, I cut the exterior, it's not gonna fit on the tile. Well, for one thing, the cardboard flexes, so in a way it will. But what you wanna do is, you want to cut it in half, and depending on how big the tile is, you may wanna cut it more than that. So we'll put it on there and see it goes on the edge. So what we'll do is we'll mark the end so we know where to glue to. And what I'll do is remove that and then glue. All the way up to where I marked. There we go. And then put that on there. You want to make sure that it's on the tile. Now it's okay if it hangs over the edge somewhat. It won't be, it'll be a little bit over the edge, unlike a regular dungeon tile. So there we go, we have the first strip on. So now here I'm going to put the second strip on. I've already glued, but you'll notice, see, that overlaps. So I want to cut a little bit of this off because I'm making it smaller than it originally was. Okay. I've got that. Now once I get all the walls on, I like to reinforce it, since with irregular shapes they generally hang over the edge. So I turn it over and I'll just take my glue gun and kind of anything, any edges going on, hanging over, I'll just reinforce it with some glue. That'll keep it from coming off later. Now another technique I like to do, which kind of simulates that this is a rough-hewn cave, is I like to take the glue gun and put some extra glue on this. Now just drag your tip through it and it'll give it kind of a rough texture. And when you put the paint on, that'll really look good. It'll look like it's a rough-hewn wall. And I'll use this technique on a lot of other water, for example. It works great for water. So then you just go around and just keep filling it in until you get the whole wall done. Very easy to do. Okay, so I've lined the tile with the glue gun. And I'll bring it in closer so you can kind of see that texture. And that'll look really nice when we paint it. It'll make it, give it an irregular texture and make it either look natural or rough-hewn. So that's kind of our tile so far. But I'd also like to add another feature to the tile. I was thinking for the story behind the cave, there's a sinkhole that the adventurers have to go further into. So there might be an encounter in the outer part in this part here, and then they have to go to a lower part. So basically, instead of attaching this tile to another one, they would go down the sinkhole, and then I would have a whole other tile that they go into. So there's an easy way to do that. So what I'll do is I'll use the pen, and I'll draw where the hole will be. So what I'll do now is I'll just cut that out. So now you can see that I've got the hole cut. So that'll be the sinkhole. And then what I'm going to do is put a bottom on it. But I don't like to use the regular thickness of cardboard because then it'll lift up the tile. So what I like to use is some kind of cardstock. You could use a cereal box. This is the back of a notepad. Anything like that. So what I'm going to do to get the size of it is I'm going to trace around the sinkhole so I kind of know how big it is, and then I'll just trace an edge around, and then I'll cut that out and we'll glue it onto the cave. So now I'll put the sinkhole on, so I'll turn the tile over. And I will use a glue gun, glue around the edge, and just put this on the bottom. So now on this side, you can see that there's still a part of a tile. But it's interesting because it looks like it actually goes into a hole. And we can paint that to accentuate that look.